the process of recording has gone from tape and analog to digital and computers, and to me that's a holiday. That's brilliant. I love it. Unfortunately, it didn't chime in with the rest of the world. It does seem to me that the people who hanker after working on tape are the ones that never did, and should they ever get to do it, they'll understand why people of my age aren't quite so keen. Slow stuff down. It kind of makes for a more gentle lifestyle. Everything moves much more gracefully when you're working on tape. However, everything gets dead boring. Come on, let's do this. All we're trying to do is edit it, whereas now that click, done, right, move on.
Okay.
And that can be good for the player.
You have no nostalgia.
No, I didn't spend 20 years working with tape. I spent 20 years working against tape, trying to make it behave itself, stop hissing, stop being dropping out, and all the other things it does that drive you mental.
Against the other, could you really tell the difference?
Yes you can if you really want to get critical about it, but I wouldn't say it was better or worse. It's different, and I think if I had to put my fiver on something, I'd put it on it on tape it sounding worse, but there you go, it's what you want. But the day-to-day running a tape is just an absolute nightmare, but in a way I'm quite nostalgic to go, I'd like to do a session that just to remind myself of whether I, you know, why I didn't like it. Maybe it does sound amazing. I don't know. I haven't heard it for 20 years. You kind of get used to it. But I have tapes that come through. I've mixed albums that were recorded essentially on tape. And other than it going tss when everyone stops playing, there isn't really a lot to be said for it.
Recording the House of Love.
I have recorded them in much more recent times, the last maybe couple of years. And we did an album about 10 years ago. And to me, it seems that they're very much the same people in the same situation and work in a very similar way, I would say. I very much enjoy working with them. And in particular, Terry, obviously, is a great guitarist and unusual, I think. I wouldn't say I've worked with anybody who works in exactly the way that Terry does. He's a bit unpredictable. You've got to let him have his leash and off he goes. And sometimes he'll get to where you and he wants to go and sometimes not, but that's fine. And he's a lovely bloke, so it's very easy to work with him, basically. And now he seems to me to always be pushing what he can do, and he's always looking for a new thing to add to the mix of the song. And can we try this and try that? He's always seems to be thinking about the song and parts that would enhance it. Destroy the Heart, and that session was very much layered. And my main memory of it is that the first thing we recorded was like an 8-bar or possibly even a 4-bar section that was the bridge from the verse to the chorus. That was the first section of the song that got worked on. We would have probably done the drums and possibly the bass, but the guitars were a patchwork quilt, and that was the idea. They set out to do that. And we did something amazing, like 16 tracks of guitars, and then bounced that down to a stereo sound on the bridge. It's a bit of a weird way to start a song, work on this tiny little bit over here when, you know, there's all the rest of it. But they had a very clear idea of what they wanted. Then, you know, it wasn't a kind of, oh, let's just try 16 guitars going, right, we're going to put this bit, then there's that bit, and then this will give us the sound. And it did, and it was great.
And were the songs on the first album, were they very worked out?
To me they were, yes. And when they came in, there was no element of writing in the studio at all. I mean, possibly editing guitar parts and this is working and this isn't, and maybe we need something extra here. But the actual songs, I think, were very done. You know, there was no element mucking about.
And of course that was in the days of analogue, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
Yes. So I suppose the process is very, very different now, isn't it?
It's not very different, no. I'd say it's the same. It's much quicker. Whether or not that's just because working in a computer is quicker or because the budgets are smaller or both, I'm not sure. But, yeah, everything moves way, way faster now than you accepted it would back then. So we didn't spend a long time. I'd imagine we probably spent maybe 2 or 3 days per track max. But now that would be considerably less, probably a day a track. And, well, but just mixing, I mean, one assumed you were going to spend at least 4 or 5 hours mixing a track, and that, well, for me, that isn't how it works anymore. You're mixing as you go, basically.